Alicia Flores, the CEO of L&L Hawaiian Barbecue, up next. How are you?
I'm doing great. I think you brought all the people with a similar sounding name up first.
I think so. Yeah. And you and I talked about having similar sound. I think you also get the award for furthest traveled.
I always win that award.
Yes, yeah. I would challenge anybody. If anybody here is further away from Hawaii, then I apologize. But thank you for joining us and for joining us on stage. I want to talk about, obviously, L&L Barbecue. It's growing pretty significantly. I believe sales last year were up 11%, footprint up 6.1% per Technomic data. And I'm curious, you know, last year that was pretty anomalous. But what is driving, you know, your brand growth? And then we'll zoom out because we're going to talk about the category at large too.
Yeah, you know, I think it's a Hawaiian barbecue category is growing. We'll talk about that. But I was reflecting on this, and it feels like there's kind of a renaissance of Asian food right now. You know, previously it was Panda Express and sushi. And now they're, you know, the hottest concepts are the hot pot concepts. You see a lot of ramen expanding as well. And I think Hawaiian barbecue is on this wave as well. So from the consumer pool side, there's a lot of demand. And then from the franchisee side, we have an interesting, you know, L&L has a very interesting background. But we've got this huge demand from franchisees driving our store count growth. So we're founded and based in Hawaii, and I have a lot of franchisees who have Hawaii ties. I have one in the audience here, Henry, with Super Order. He and his sister are from Hawaii. I'm proud to share that we will be opening three stores in New York City. He will be opening three stores in New York City. But why they were attracted to L&L is because they're from Hawaii. Mm-hmm. They're on the continent now. They miss home. Mm-hmm. They miss the food. They love what Hawaii has to offer, and they want to bring that to their community.
Sure. When we talked, you extensively went into that culture driven by your franchisees.
Yes.
And I know we talked about your differentiators too, and you put it pretty simply, hey, we're based in Hawaii, you know, so tell me about that culture and how you're able to maintain that, because you're, what, 45 years old?
Yes, yeah. So it's
not you, the brand.
I'm almost 45 years old. So we're founded and headquartered in Hawaii. We will always be headquartered in Hawaii. We want to stay true to our brand. Actually, the term Hawaiian barbecue, my dad's the founder, it was a term he created when we brought the concept to the continent in the 90s. So Hawaiian barbecue, we are Hawaiian barbecue. We're also the only brand on the continent where you can also, we're the only plate lunch brand that you can also get if you visit Hawaii. Mm-hmm. So we're really proud of those things. We call ourselves the original Hawaiian barbecue. When we think about the foundational values as well, you know, a lot of times you'll hear the terms aloha and ohana. We are living it, my office is living it every day. We see it every day because we're in Hawaii. We make our franchisees come to Hawaii for training. So even if they have never been to Hawaii before, they have to come to Hawaii to experience that. So I think those are our differentiators, and I think that makes us unique. It also attracts the type of franchisee and customer that we're really proud of.
Mm-hmm. You talked earlier about sort of this Asian food wave. How much of this is demographically driven? Because when I was pouring through Technomic data, noticing, you know, the acceleration, if you will, of the Hawaiian barbecue category. You've got some competitors out there, and they all have a pretty good momentum behind them. And when I dove into that research, it showed that in 2020, it was the first time that more Hawaiians lived on the mainland than on the islands. Do you believe that's part of the drive here behind the categorical competition?
I think it's some of the drive, you know, but if you look at so Hawaii has a population of 1.4 million. I think Native Hawaiian populations just under 700,000. You know, even if all of those people were in one state, that's not enough to sustain a restaurant. So, you know, I think that's part of the reason. Our best way for people to experience L&L is if someone who knows us takes a friend there, so that's helpful in that respect. But for us, I think, again, what's really driving that is our franchisee. Our largest cohort of franchisees are people who have a strong tie to Hawaii and have a real big desire to bring that to their community.
Okay. You are at about, 230 units now in 15 states?
That's right.
So you have some white space here.
We have a lot of white space.
I'm going to ask you the same question that I asked Alex. What's our conversation going to be like? What's your next?
Yeah, so my goal is to get us to 500 units. Mm-hmm. And kind of like how Alex was saying, we want to grow. I could say 1,000, I could say 5,000. But I think 500 for us would be pretty big expansion, doubling our footprint. We're already on kind of this curve up faster than we've been before. And I want to make sure we continue to have that magic, kind of what you're saying, in the type of franchisees that we have and the culture that we have. I think at 500, we'll take a pause and make sure as a brand, we're still where we want to be. Mm-hmm. But I think, you know, 500 is a great number and we'll get to Louisville at some point.
I was gonna push you on that. Until you get to Louisville, for folks like myself or in other markets where you're not quite yet, what would you tell us about your brand? What do we expect? What is L&L Hawaiian Barbecue for those of us who are not quite initiated yet?
Yes, so L&L Hawaiian Barbecue is the comfort food of Hawaii. And I think everyone can understand what comfort food is. I was sharing in my talk with Sam, I think earlier this year, so my wife is from Ohio and she never had Hawaiian barbecue food prior to coming to Hawaii. But she's had chicken fried steak, fried chicken with gravy on it. There's a similar dish that we serve at L&L. She's had, what's it called, with the hamburger steak and gravy, Salisbury steak, I think it is. Mm-hmm. Again, something we have at L&L. So these dishes where you eat and you feel like you're home, you feel your stomach is warm and full, that's what L&L Hawaiian Barbecue serves, but it's, you know, with a Hawaii twist to it.
Okay. Well, what is the top seller?
Our number one seller by unit count is the Spam Musubi.
I was gonna ask about Spam.
Yeah, it's like a Spam sushi. Yeah, we sell so many of those. And a lot of people, if they've never had it before, so Spam is also like a state food of Hawaii. Mm-hmm. If you've never had it before, they're very like, ooh, Spam, but it is delicious.
Yeah, I won't be elitist about Spam ever, I promise you that. What is your favorite dish?
My favorite dish is a chicken katsu.
Okay.
So I think I've had fried chicken here twice since being in Nashville. Chicken katsu is Hawaii's version of fried chicken. It's panko breaded deep fried chicken and it's delicious.
Okay. And we talked about the competitive pressures, earlier, the not just the category growing in Hawaiian barbecue proper, but the Asian category, I would argue globally inspired overall. So, you know, where do you find your place there? Where are you going to maintain an edge as more consumers become aware of what you're doing and what your competitors are doing?
Yeah, you know, I think where our edge is so we're 100% franchise. Mm-hmm. Our edge is, I think, the franchisees that we bring in, and they're all entrepreneurs. They are the definition of entrepreneurs. And because of that, the way they run their store, they want to build a community. They want to have great employees who enjoy working for them and the brand. They want to have great customer base and give back to the communities they're in. I think that's something we're really proud of, and I think something that we want to continue to bring forward.
Sure. Well, and as you grow, what are you going to look for in franchisees to maintain, you know, your family's culture that started this brand, this culture that you spoke at length about?
Yeah. So
what do you look for?
So one of the unique things that I love about our founding is my parents are both immigrants to the United States, and they grew up in conditions I can't even imagine. And I'm very lucky. I've had a very nice life because for my family, L&L was their American dream come true. And what I love seeing is that for every one of my franchisees, the reason that they want to own a restaurant, the reason they want to open an L&L is because it is their American dream. It's their families. It's the legacy they want to create for their family. And so that's what I really look for, that the franchisee that's coming in, telling me these things, telling me these stories of they want to open this up for their kids, they want to bring the brand to their community. That's what we look for, and that's where the real magic is.
Very good. Well, like Alex, we'll continue this conversation, and thank you again. I know you had some travel issues. I won't disclose them, but traveling with a two-year-old is not easy.
It's not
you know,
easy.
Many of us know that. So thank you for joining us, and we'll catch up.